I remember being at Robert Lang's studio in Seattle for a Nirvana session. The last time we ever recorded together, we recorded with Adam Kasper, who was a great producer in town, a Seattle guy. And at that session, he came in with the new Soundgarden, and it was before it was released. And he said, "Hey, do you guys want to hear the stuff we just recorded for the new Soundgarden record?" And me and Chris Novoselic said, "Yeah, put it on." And he played Black Hole Sun. And I remember thinking, holy shit, this is going to be huge. This will be enormously huge, because to me, it was that perfect meeting of the Beatles and Black Sabbath, which is, I think, what we put in our Nirvana bio. Like, you know, we sound like ABBA and Black Sabbath, or the Beatles and Black Sabbath or something, but I don't think that had ever successfully been paired until that record, and in particular that song. It was just so, it was so much more melodically sophisticated than anything any of the other bands in Seattle were doing, or in rock. Like, it was a big deal. But, you know, I remember discovering Soundgarden in the mid to late 80s and thinking, wow, this is so cool. This is a rock band that's surviving and thriving in this underground scene, which can sometimes not want to support rock bands. Like, to me, they had that punk rock underground do-it-yourself ethic, but they were playing really interesting rock music, you know. So anyway, I think since Soundgarden was always that band in Seattle that sort of went first, you know, they were the first band to get out, they were the first band to sort of break, and the first band to do the major label thing, and within the underground scene, it only made sense that they were the first band to write a song like Black Hole Sun that was just such a forget about it being a hit song that you still hear on the radio 10 times a day, but just to write that song and to record it so that forever you'll know, like, wow, that's the band that could do that thing, because nobody else could do that. And that record was, you know, it was such a, it really just raised the bar for everyone. Sonically, it was way beyond anything anybody had done within our scene. Melodically, again, just so much more sophisticated than anything else we felt like we were capable of doing. And then, you know, the performance, it's like, they're just amazing players. Chris's voice, nobody had a voice like Chris. Nobody played drums like Matt. You know, they were an incredible band. And 20 years later, like, that's one of those records that I honestly feel like your kid or your kids will discover and say, like, wow, Dad, do you know about that band Soundgarden? 25 years from now. And you'll say, yeah, I know about Soundgarden. They're pretty good.
There are a lot of people in the town. And usually when there's a large city, there are a lot of bands. I don't know why they're all good. But those bands that you just mentioned, Tad, Mudhoney, and Soundgarden, are pretty much the only bands from Seattle I personally have liked. The rest of them I don't really care for that much, so I think there are at least a handful of good bands in every city.